In this tutorial, we will learn about combining selections. Firstly, we will select both the window frame and the little arch above it so that we can darken it and make it appear as if it is receding a bit deeper into the wall. In order to do such a thing, we will have to make use of a combination of both rectangular and elliptical marquee tool. We will first start by using the elliptical marquee tool. We will imagine that there is a straight line going across the top of the arch and meeting with another imaginary vertical line on the left-hand side of the window. This is where our selection will begin. We will select using the elliptical marquee and make any necessary adjustment to our selection by releasing the cursor and then select Transform Selection under the Select menu. We can choose any anchor point and use it in order to resize and reshape our selection. There is no need to worry as we are not changing the pixels of the picture. We are only transforming the selection. If we now hold down our Windows key and click drag on any of the corner points of the image, we can distort the selection. In order to commit to this distorted transformation, we need to click on the check mark. Now, in order to add the rest of the window, we will switch over to the rectangular marquee tool and hold the shift key to add to the selection. Now, in order to add the rest of the window, we need to start at the lower left-hand corner and click drag upwards. Now, you might notice that we have selected a little more than we needed on the left-hand side. In order to remove the extra area, we need to hold down the Alt key. We will start off by selecting the area on the outside and click drag it upwards in order to remove that area. We will do a similar thing on the right side in order to remove any extra bit of selection. We will now go ahead and deselect the glass, but also make sure that the window panes and this wooden area remain selected. However, it will be easier if we just hold down the Alt key and then click drag to deselect the entire window and then hold down the Shift key so that we can reselect the little dividers. We will now click drag over here 2 times and then click drag down from the top. We can easily use Ctrl plus Z to undo something in case we wanted to. Now, we will hold the Shift key again and drag that back out. We have not discussed much about the adjustment of layers so far, but we will go to the layer menu and choose a new layer and set a particular brightness and contrast for it. Let us name this layer as Darken Window and click OK to proceed. Notice that we do not have the marching ants anymore. That is because when we add an adjustment layer in Photoshop and have a selection, Photoshop turns the selection into a layer mask. This layer mask can be seen in the Layers panel. If any layer mask is black, it will hide any adjustment that we make, whereas if the layer is white, the adjustments we make will be revealed. In case we bring the brightness slider to the left and darken it, and move the contrast slider to the right to add contrast, we can see that the adjustments being made are visible only in the white areas in the image area. But adding the adjustment layer, we can always come back to it and make any change we desire, like changing the mask, adjustment settings, brightness, and contrast, thus making it flexible for us. Let us now take a quick look at the mask, for which we will hold down the Alt key and click on the mask icon in the Layers panel. We can see that this mask is hard edged. If we click on the eye icon in order to take a look at the image again, we can see the hard edges in the image area, which tell us that few areas in the image have not been adjusted well. To make these areas softer, we can use the feather slider and move it a little on the right. We keep moving it to the right until the hard edges are no longer there, or when the image is to our liking. If we now Alt-click on the mask, we can see what we have done by adding the feather or softening the hard parts of the image, which makes it difficult for someone to make out which parts have been adjusted and which parts have not. We will click on the eye icon again and quickly refine the feather and close the properties panel. We can click on the eye icon to see the before and after effects, as we can see this as before and this is after. So as you have seen, it helps us to figure out which areas to select and break down the area into basic components. This way, we can use a combination of rectangular and elliptical marquee tool to make a selection quickly.